I will show you how you can remove background in 5 seconds with Preview on Mac. It works great 90% of the time, and for the times when you get a more complex image, there are 3 other ways to remove the background, still with Preview. If you own a Mac, it is a free application on your computer. Let's test it out with a few images. Double-click on an image to open it in Preview, or right-click on the image and select Preview. I have an image of a family here and I want to remove the background. Go to Tools, scroll down to remove background. Don't click on it just yet, just hover over it with your cursor. See what's happening? You will see this white line outlining your image and showing you what will be kept when you select the remove background. Once you click on the remove background, you're left with just the family. And what a great job it did! You can see that it even removed these 3 tricky sections between their arms and heads. Let's do another one. I have an image of a German Shepherd here, and we'll do the same. The remove background tool did a great job considering we have fur to deal with, which can be complex. And here I have a picture of me and my cat Rio. I will remove background again, but this time I get a message that this image will be converted from JPEG to PNG because PNG supports transparency, which is what we are doing, making the background transparent. I will click convert. Wow, that was pretty cool, considering that we are dealing not only with my hair, but also a furry animal. As I previously mentioned, this tool doesn't always work. For example, for this image, when I go to tools and scroll down, the remove background option is grayed out because it doesn't recognize what is a background in the screenshot image of a browser window. But that is okay. Preview has few other ways to remove backgrounds in the more challenging photos. Here is another photo that the remove background tool doesn't work as well as we would wanted it to. When I select remove background, I can see what items the tool recognized to keep when it outlines it with the shiny highlighter. I can see that the adorable bulldog is not highlighted, therefore it will be removed as part of the background. The reason why is that the contrast between the white background and the white marks on the dog's face makes it difficult for the tool to tell where does the background begin. But we can easily fix that with the other options that Preview has. When I take screenshots of menu items, I like to remove all the clutter behind to only keep the menu items in focus. I can use Preview to remove them by first activating the markup options at the top right, then going to selection tools at the very left of the toolbar and selecting the rectangular selection. I would use the elliptical selection if I had any oval objects in my image. Now I will select sections to delete. I can approximate the area and then use the dashed border to adjust the fit. Once I'm happy, I will press delete. I will continue doing that for the rest of the areas and only keep the menu section visible. It may take you a few deletions before you're satisfied. Third way to remove background is by using the instant alpha tool. I'm going to reopen the image where the background was not recognized with the remove background tool. Then I'm going to activate markup tool. I could use the rectangular selections to remove the areas around the Google page, but there is an even easier option. Next to the selection tools is Instant Alpha, which looks a bit like a magic wand. Now I will pick an area that I want to remove. Click on the area with your mouse or trackpad and drag it up or down. The red area indicates what will be removed. If you see that your selection is covering part of the image you want to keep, move your mouse or finger in the opposite direction to deselect it. Once you release your finger, dashed lines will indicate areas for deletion. Click delete when you are ready. You can also always undo with Command plus Z if you make a mistake. The trick is to make smaller selections one at a time. The Instant Alpha really shines when you want to mask text. I can either remove the background and then clean up any leftovers inside the letters, or make the letters transparent with the Instant Alpha. Another quick method, which works better for certain fonts, is selecting the background with Instant Alpha, then going to Edit, Invert Selection, and delete the letter fill. Now, it may not work well with too many closed letters, so selecting them individually may be the preferred method. Now let's go back to the image of the dogs. So when we try to remove the background, our cute bulldog is removed because of the low contrast of his white marking and the white background. We could use the Instant Alpha tool, which does a pretty decent job, and then remove any extra areas that were left around the dogs. But there are also 2 lasso options under the selection tools that we can use to isolate our puppy. Let's select the selection tools and pick the lasso selection. It's good to zoom in on your subject to be more precise in making the selection. Then drag the mouse pointer around the bulldog. If you let go of your mouse or trackpad, you will lose your selection, which is frustrating to have to do it again. What is better to avoid this frustration is to cast a wider area and then clean it up in smaller selections. If I go to tools and crop, I will only have our bulldog. I would have to select the other dogs, or we can combine different tools to do that, which I will show you in a minute. Let's first compare the smart lasso, which is a little less sensitive than the regular lasso and provides some automatic selection closer to our subject outline. Now, once I make a selection, I will make a copy of the bulldog and go to File, New from Clipboard to keep a copy of our selection. Now I will go back to our image and use the fastest tool in our disposal, which is the Remove Background tool. So our cute bulldog disappears, but we save the nicely selected copy in our temporary file. So I will go to Window and bring up the file. I will select it with Command A and copy it with Command plus C, then go back to my dog picture and paste our bulldog with Command plus V. I will reposition it and voila! You'll learn 4 different methods to remove background in Preview. Thanks so much for watching!